Yes, now we'll discuss about the palatine tonsil. This topic is clinically and exam point of view very important. Palatine tonsil is a almond shaped tonsil present in tonsillar fossa. So first of all, we'll make a diagram of that. Tonsillar fossa, where it is situated. Here you can see this is parasagittal section of the head region. Here is this is palate, this is palate, this is soft palate, this is hard palate, and from palate a palatoglossal arch. This is palatoglossal arch and this is palatopharyngeal arch. So two arch descends downward, palatoglossal and palatopharyngeal. This is tongue. This is tongue. This is tongue. So palatoglossal arch and palatopharyngeal arch. If you see from anterior side, this diagram will be this is palate and here is this is tongue. This is anterior two-third part of the tongue. This is anterior two-third part of the tongue. This is posterior one-third part of the tongue. This part is posterior one-third part. And this is palate. This is tongue. And from palate, this is palatoglossal arch. This arch is palatoglossal arch. And another arch, this is palatopharyngeal arch. So this arch is palatopharyngeal arch. So this is palatopharyngeal and palatoglossal. This is palatoglossal and this arch is palatopharyngeal arch. As you know, in palatoglossal arch, palatoglossus muscle is present, and here in palatopharyngeal arch, palatopharyngeous muscle goes into the pharynx. Palatopharyngeous muscle goes into the pharynx, and as you know, this muscle also from the piceavent ridge, it goes backward and form a U-shaped sling with opposite side muscle. So this is palate, this is palatoglossal arch, palatopharyngeal arch, and here is position of this is position of the this is position of the palatine tonsil. This is palatine tonsil. So you can see here, if see this is fossa, tonsillar fossa, boundary of the tonsillar fossa, anteriorly it is bounded by palatoglossal arch, this is palatoglossal arch, posteriorly by palatopharyngeal arch, palatopharyngeal arch, and it has anterior and posterior boundary. Apex is formed by joining up these two arch. Apex is formed here at the palate, and base is formed by here. You can see this base is formed by the dorsum of the tongue, posterior one third part of the dorsum of the tongue. So this is tonsillar fossa, where almond shaped palatine tonsil is present. This palatine tonsil is mostly known as tonsil. So this is palatine tonsil. If you cut a horizontal section, if you cut the horizontal section, you will find there are 12 to 15 crypts. These are the tonsillar crypts. There are small tonsillar crypts. Their number is 12 to 15 tonsillar crypts. And one crypt is large. This develops from the second pharyngeal pouch. And this is crypta magna. This is known as crypta magna. आर इंट्रा टॉन्सिलर क्लेफ्ट. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इंट्रा टॉन्सिलर क्लेफ्ट. So this is large and this develops from the second pharyngeal pouch. So here you can see this is horizontal section. If you cut a horizontal section, then there is anterior pillar, here is anterior boundary, this is posterior boundary. As you know, anterior boundary is formed by palatoglossal arch. So this is palatoglossal arch. Here is palatoglossus muscle is present. So this arch is palatoglossal arch. And here this arch is palatopharyngeal arch. This is palatopharyngeal arch. So this is palatoglossal. This is palatoglossal arch and palatoglossal muscle. This is palatopharyngeal arch and this arch is formed by palatopharyngeus muscle. This is anterior boundary, posterior boundary, and this is covered by hemicapsule. Posteriorly on lateral side you can see this is covered by fibrous tissue which form the hemicapsule. This is hemicapsule. This is tonsillar hemicapsule. It is fibrous tissue. This is tonsillar hemicapsule. This is fibrous tissue. So this is fibrous tissue through which it is covered on lateral side. And another thing, here is loose connective tissue. After this, there is loose connective tissue. Lateral to this, there is loose connective tissue. This loose connective tissue form the peritonsillar space. This form the peritonsillar space. This is peritonsillar space. Sometimes pus is formed here. If infection from the tonsil goes to this, then pus is formed. Then peritonsillar abscess is formed here. And one important structure present here, that is one vein. There is paratonsillar vein. Here lies paratonsillar vein. This vein is very important. Paratonsillar vein. This vein is clinically very important because during removal of the tonsillectomy, this vein become the most important cause of the bleeding. So this paratonsillar vein is clinically very important. And after this, there is tonsillar bed. Tonsillar bed lies here. This is tonsillar bed. Just after to this, the anther structure where it rests, this is tonsillar bed. It is formed by pharyngobasilar fascia. This is pharyngo basilar fascia. And lateral to this, there is superior constrictor muscle. So lateral to this, there is superior constrictor muscle. This muscle is superior constrictor muscle. Superior constrictor of the pharynx. And just lateral to this, there is another structure. This is buccopharyngeal fascia. This is buccopharyngeal fascia. Anther fascia. And more lateral to this, there is, here is the, this is rhymus of the mandible, and here is position of the medial pterygoid muscle.
And also here is parapharyngeal venous plexus. So here is parapharyngeal venous plexus. Parapharyngeal venous plexus. So this parapharyngeal venous plexus is again very important, because this paratonsillar vein ultimately drains into the parapharyngeal venous plexus by passing to these structures. Another thing is the artery. Here is position of the artery. This is, here is facial artery. Facial artery, it gives branches. Facial artery gives ascending palatine branch, which gives branch to the tonsil. And here is position of the submandibular gland. Submandibular salivary gland is lies here. So these three structures are very important. These structures form the tonsillar bed is formed by these three structures. Another important thing is the external feature of the tonsil. So you can see tonsil has here, it is almond shaped, it has upper pole, this pole is upper pole. In this position you can see this is upper pole, which even reach into this palate, and lower pole reach up to the tongue, and it has medial surface. You can see this is medial surface. This medial surface is covered by non-keratinized. This is covered by non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. So this surface is covered by, medial surface is covered by non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. And this lateral surface, as you know here, this is covered by hemicapsule. This is hemicapsule, and also related to these structures. So upper pole, lower pole, medial surface, two surface, medial surface and lateral surface. So these are the anterior border and posterior borders. Upper pole, lower pole, medial surface, lateral surface, and anterior and posterior border. This is anterior. In this section you can see this is anterior border, this is posterior border. Anterior border is related with the palatoglossal arch and palatoglossal muscle, and posterior border is related with the palatopharyngeal arch and palatopharyngeus muscle. So these are external features. Now arterial supply of the tonsil. So if you see here, this is tonsil, this is cleft, and these are the numerous crypts, tonsillar crypts. And artery, you can see here, this is common carotid artery. This is common carotid artery. It divides into internal carotid. This is internal carotid artery. And here is external carotid artery. So this is external carotid artery. And this external carotid artery gives a branch. This is maxillary artery. So maxillary artery gives one branch. This branch is descending palatine branch, also it is known as greater palatine. This branch is known as greater palatine artery, greater palatine, and this gives tonsillar branch. So greater palatine artery gives tonsillar branch, which is a branch of maxillary artery. This is a branch of external carotid artery. This is internal carotid artery. So this is branch of maxillary artery, is a branch of external carotid artery, and it gives greater palatine, and this greater palatine gives tonsillar branch. It gives ascending pharyngeal. This artery is ascending pharyngeal artery. This artery. it gives tonsillar branch. Another artery here is lingual artery. This is lingual artery. Lingual artery gives dorsal lingui. These branches are dorsal lingui, and these dorsal lingui gives tonsillar branches. So these are tonsillar branches. Here is facial artery. This is facial artery, gives tonsillar branch, and facial artery also gives ascending palatine artery. This is ascending palatine artery. Ascending palatine artery, this ascending palatine gives tonsillar branch. So here you can see these are the five branches of the external carotid artery gives supply to the tonsil. Venous drainage through the paratonsillar vein, and from paratonsillar vein blood goes into this venous plexus, parapharyngeal venous plexus. And lymphatic drainage, lymphatics from the tonsil goes to deep cervical group of lymph node, especially jugulodigastic lymph node. And nerve supply, glossopharyngeal nerve. Nerve supply is glossopharyngeal and lesser palatine. Nerve is glossopharyngeal plus lesser palatine. Lesser palatine is a branch of sphenopalatine. So this is all about the palatine tonsil. Thank you.